What's going on YouTube? This is JabberTech. This is the newly released Mobvoi TicWatch E2, and at $159, it's super budget friendly. It's a very capable smartwatch, but is it worth it over the TicWatch Pro? Let's get into this review and talk about it together. For those of you that don't know, Mobvoi is the company that's really responsible for keeping the WearOS platform alive and relevant. All other companies have pretty much forgotten about WearOS for the moment, but not Mobvoi. They're really giving us some great styles and different watches for different types of people, and that's where the E2 comes into. At only $159, this watch is a great budget-friendly watch, a great starter watch, but more importantly, this is a great gym buddy, a great gym partner to help you get in shape this season. And the E2, while it might be $159, the TicWatch Pro is regularly on sale for $199. Check my link down below, but it retails for $250, and that should be your everyday watch. The E2, with its plastic polycarbonate build, is really very light and very durable, but it's not something you'd want to wear with a suit. This is really intended to be your gym buddy, your workout partner again, whereas the TicWatch Pro over there at $249 has a little bit better premium styling to it with the stainless steel build, but the $159 E2 is something that I can recommend if you want to use a watch just for the gym, if you want to use a watch to just track your steps from time to time, track your heart rate, go for a run with. This is where the TicWatch E2 really shines. And at $159, it's very affordable, very attainable for pretty much everybody. But there are some differences between the E2 and the Pro, and I want you guys to understand those differences before you choose the wrong smartwatch, before you choose something that you're not going to enjoy, because a smartwatch should make your life a lot more enjoyable. No matter which one you choose, you're going to get the same internals, so you're going to get that Wear 2100 processor. You're also going to get a beautiful 1.39-inch 400x400 panel, which gets super bright in daylight. I've had no problems reading this in direct sunlight. You also get continuously monitoring heart rate on the bottom, and you do have pogo pins for charging on both of these. Not to mention you have changeable 22mm style bands. We all like to change out the bands and make these watches our own. Other than that, you do have the same battery, 415mAh batteries, but one of these watches is going to offer you better battery life, and that's the TicWatch Pro with that dual layer screen. That really helps to save battery. The E2 does not have that dual layer technology, so you'll get a solid 1 day of usage with the TicWatch E2, whereas the TicWatch Pro, you'll get about 2 to 3 days with just about my usage, just about average usage. Now, of course, that's with always on display active. That's with the heart rate monitoring set to continuously monitor. You can turn that off and choose to manually monitor your heart rate, but why would you want to do that, guys? And of course, why would you want to turn off the always on display? The whole point of having a watch is to be able to tell time when you look at it. That's just my opinion, but don't expect to get the 2 days. I really have not been able to get 2 days. The most I got with this is a day and a half, and that was really with turning off the key features, which I don't recommend you guys do. And why I say the E2 is really not designed to be that everyday watch is because Mobvoi left out some key things that should be on a smartwatch if you're using it as your primary daily driver. And those things are an ambient light sensor, which is not found on the E2, but that is found on the TicWatch Pro. So you will have to manually dim or brighten the screen based on your environment. That's really a big deal if you're using a watch as an everyday watch, guys. You don't want to continuously have to go in and manually set the brightness. But on a watch that's designed to be your gym partner, your workout buddy, you do not need that ambient light sensor. And that's how you save some money. That's how you do some cost cutting. That's how you keep the price point low. Another thing that Mobvoi left out is NFC, so you cannot make payments on this watch. That's something that I would have liked to have been included, even if it is a gym watch, a workout buddy, because when you're out, maybe you want to go for a run and not take your wallet. So I'm hoping the next iteration of this gym watch will have NFC built in. The TicWatch Pro, of course, does have NFC. Another main differentiator between these two watches is that the E2 does not have a speaker, but it does have a microphone, guys. So you will be able to dictate text messages, and you'll be able to query the Google Assistant with your voice. No problems doing that at all. But making and taking calls from your wrist is not going to happen on the E2. And again, that's perfectly fine. You're really not taking phone calls at the gym when you're doing your thing. Another key differentiator, and this is huge, guys, the TicWatch E2 has a 5 ATM rating, Whereas the TicWatch Pro over there just has an IP68 rating. So it's really intended to be your swimming buddy, your workout buddy. So you can take this and track your laps, and that'll happen automatically thanks to the Tic Exercise suite of applications here. You have the setting for swim, but it'll automatically track it, and there will be an update coming later on that'll do sleep tracking and will automatically detect and start your workouts based on whatever you're doing. I don't know if that's going to make it to the TicWatch Pro, but it's definitely coming to the E2. So if you go out for a run and you forget to press start, this will automatically track it, and that's something super cool, and that's something that makes the E2 really designed for that play, for that gym aspect of your life. And they both have GPS chips inside, which is very strong. Now, I have not been able to run outside. It's been just a little bit too cold here in New York City. But if it's anything like the TicWatch Pro, the GPS held a very strong signal, was pretty accurate, and I had no problems with the GPS signal or the step tracking on the TicWatch Pro or on the E2. Step tracking has been really good on this. This being an Android Wear device, you can choose to keep TicWatch's application, or you can use the Google Fit software if you want, or you can use pretty much anything else. That's what's great about the WearOS platform. You really have a choice, but I've really been using Mobvoi's suite of applications because I think they're really good. I like the amount of information that they give us, and it's really super easy to use. This will be your daily summary, guys. So if you go through the different days, you can track your workouts, track whatever you've done, your steps, your heart rate, etc., etc. And I think it gives you just about enough information that most of us will want to keep track of. So you'll see you'll be able to keep track of your exercise minutes. You can keep track of your steps, your active hours, your calories burned, your distance, your average heart rate. And then of course you get some nice graphs. And if you do go for a run with this, and this is pretty much the information that you're going to see, you're going to see your duration, your distance, your calories burned, average heart rate, average speed. You'll also see these nice graphs of your heart rate there. You'll see your pace, you'll see your step frequency and your step length. So again, guys, I really like the Tic suite of applications here, but if you don't want to use it, you can use Runtastic, you can use Strava, you can use anything that you want because this is a Wear OS device. And speaking of Wear OS devices, you have the Google Assistant built in here and it's really capable. I'd say this is the best assistant to have on your wrist, and you can just ask it questions and the microphone has been able to pick up everything that I've mentioned. What's the weather today? Who's the president of the United States? And you also get images as well, guys. So the Google Assistant built in on this watch has just been excellent. When was he born? You have those contextual follow-up questions as well, so you don't have to keep asking who is Donald Trump, when was he born, etc., etc. That's what makes the E2 a very capable watch. So if you did even want to use this as a daily watch, guys, just keep in mind that the styling is a little bit different and it's not going to look really great with a suit on. That's where the TicWatch Pro will come into place. When you wear a suit, this guy is just going to creep along and look a little bit better than the E2 will. But the E2 is very capable. It's something that I can highly recommend, especially if you're looking for that gym partner, that workout buddy, designed to be that workout watch, designed to give you all the motivation in terms of fitness tracking that you need in a smart package, in a very affordable package here. And if you use this watch for what it's intended to be, I think you're going to be super happy. I really appreciate you watching, guys. Thumbs up, subscribe. Let me know if you have any questions about this in the comments down below. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you guys next time.